डिस्टेंस, यूज सोशल डिस्टेंस, मेंटेन द सोशल डिस्टेंस, यूज मास्क एंड यूज सैनिटाइजर एंड वॉश योर हैंड्स रेगुलरली. ओके नाउ इन द प्रीवियस सेशन व्हाट वी लर्न, थ्री प्रॉपर्टीज ओवर, कम्यूटेटिव क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी, एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी एंड कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी फॉर ऑल थ्री सेट ऑफ नंबर्स फॉर अंडर फोर मैथमेटिकल ऑपरेशंस वी डिड. ओके मैम, नाउ इन लास्ट सेशन क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट दैट एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी एंड मल्टीप्लिकेटिव आइडेंटिटी. वॉट इज एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी, विच नंबर यू विल कॉल एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी?
जीरो.
यस, जीरो इज एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी. मीन्स इफ यू आर जीरो टू एनी नंबर यू आर गेटिंग द नंबर इटसेल्फ ओनली. नाउ सिमिलरली वन, वन इज कॉल्ड मल्टीप्लिकेटिव आइडेंटिटी. इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई एनी नंबर by one, the product become the number itself only. So this we learn. Now today we learn about additive inverse. What is mean by additive inverse? Additive inverse. Suppose a is a number. So what is the additive inverse of a? Minus a. Additive inverse of a is minus a, and if you take minus a is the additive inverse. So both are additive inverse to each other. Understood? So suppose if you take 2, what is the additive inverse of 2? Additive inverse of 2 is minus 2. Similarly, additive inverse of minus 2 is 2. Okay, so for all a, the additive inverse is minus a. Means just you have to change the sign. If positive sign is given, you have to write negative sign. If negative number is given, you have to write positive number. That only. That is the additive inverse. Okay, now, so what is the additive inverse of a? Minus a. Now, multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse. What is multiplicative inverse? Reciprocal. Reciprocal of any number is the multiplicative inverse of that number. For example, 3. What is the multiplicative inverse of that number? Multiplicative inverse of 3. Reciprocal of that number, I said no. So here, how can you take the reciprocal? If the denominator will be there. Here denominator not there, no, only 3 I given. So if denominator not there, means every number is having 1 as the denominator if denominator is not given. So 3 by 1 is the fraction. So what is the reciprocal of 3 by 1? 1 by 3. So 3, for 3 the reciprocal is 1 by 3. Reciprocal is nothing but interchanging of numerator and denominator. So if you multiply this, if you multiply the given number by its reciprocal, then you are getting as 1. Then it become the multiplicative inverse to each other. So see, 3 ones are 3 ones are, and 1 1 will cancel, you are getting 0. Similarly in the additive inverse also, what the number you are taking, its additive inverse, if you add it, the sum becomes 0. For example, 2. What is the additive inverse of 2? Minus 2, no? So, you are adding. Here, minus 2. 2 plus of minus 2 is equal to, what you are getting? 0. See, 2 plus into minus minus 2. Plus 2 minus 2 become 0. So, number and its additive inverse become 0. Sum of the number and its additive inverse become 0. Similarly, number and its reciprocal, the product become 1. So, a is a number and its multiplicative inverse is 1 by a. Then if you multiply this, the product become 1. See, a will cancel. 1 only. So, 1. Understood? Now, distributive law. What is mean by distributive property? Distributive property, we can say that multiplication over addition. Distributive multiplication over addition. This is last property. Distributive property is nothing but multiplication over addition. So how can we write the statement of this? A into B plus C. A into B plus C is equal to. See how it is multiplication over addition, because here there is no simple multiplication. This is bracket I given now. So A into multiplication. Addition, over addition. So how can you elaborate this one? A into B, AB plus A into C, AC. Understood? So A into B, AB plus A into C, AC. This is called distributive law. Multiplication over addition. So for this one we will see example. For example, A I am taking 2. Then B I am taking 5 and C I am taking 6. Now A into B, that is 2 into 5. 2 into 5 plus 2 into 6. Now 2 into 5 plus 6 how much now? 11. That equal to, here also you have to multiply each bracket. 2 5s are 10 plus 2 6s are 12. Here 2 into 11, 11 2s are 22, 11, 10 plus 12, 22. Both sides you are getting same answer, no? So this is called distributive law or multiplication over addition. This is very very important. In 2 marks sum, definitely they will ask, show the multiplication, distributive law, multiplication over addition with one example. He will ask like that in SA1 or SA2. So 1 mark or 2 marks you will get definitely. Okay ma? Once again I will say the statement. A into B plus C is equal to AB. A into B plus A into C. Okay? So both sides you will get the same answer. This is multiplication over addition. Now, see, in your textbook, tables are there. Page number 16 and 17. All of you open your textbooks, page number 16 and 17. Here already you did in the properties in the classwork. I explained on the board also. Same. Now what you have to do? Here you have to write yes or no. Yes means closed or satisfied. No means not closed or not satisfied. So rational numbers, closure property can be satisfied under rational number, under addition. That you have to see. Already you wrote the table. So see that table and you have to write yes or no. Only to fill in the textbook with pencil. No need to copy in the classwork. Page number 16 and 17. These two tables you have to copy in the textbook only. Now, exercise 1.1. We'll start. See children. For how can you start the classwork? First you have to write the key concepts. Already you did in the 7th class. I explained how to write the classwork. So after the lesson, what we have learned is there, no? You have to put key concepts heading and write what the concepts they given. Write all the concepts. And after that, in each session, what I am writing on the board, please copy, and homework also you have to do. Okay? So like this you can complete your classwork. Okay, now exercise 1.1. Open your textbook, page number 19. Page number 19. Exercise 1.1. See, first one. You can fill in the textbook. Afterwards, you can copy in the classroom. With pencil. Take the pencil. I will say the answer. You can fill. Now, see. Name the property involved in the following examples. First one. 8 by 5 plus 0 is equal to 8 by 5. And 0 plus 8 by 5. So, which property this is? What you are doing here? You are adding 0. You are adding 0 to the rational number. So, again you are getting the rational number itself. So which property it is? Additive identity. Write down there. Additive identity. Second one is in the form of A of B plus C. That is A into B plus C. Which not only I said which property that is? Distributive property. Write down there. Distributive property. Now third one. 3 by 7 into 1 is equal to 3 by 7. Again, 1 into 3 by 7. So, which property that is? By 1 we are multiplying. So, it is which one? Multiplicative identity. Here, 2 are involved. This is addition. Commutative property under addition also it will come. Here, commutative property under multiplication also will come. Again, additive identity will come. Here multiplicative identity will come. But mainly we are seeing that 0 and 1 is there. That's why you have to use that property's name only. Okay. So that's why first one is additive identity. Second one is third one is multiplicative identity. Now fourth one. Multiplicative identity. By 1 only they are multiplying. Now fifth one. 2 by 5 plus 1 by 3 is equal to 1 by 3 plus 2 by 5. Here no need to solve. In this first sum, how many bits are given? No need to solve. Just you have to write the property name only. Now, 4 fifth one. A plus B into A plus B is equal to B plus A. Which property? Plus is there and changing of the numbers. So, it is commutative property under addition. Under which operation? That also you have to mention. Commutative property under addition. Now, sixth one. 5 by 2 into 3 by 7 is equal to 15 by 14. Only one multiplication is given. So, it is closure property under multiplication. Seventh one. 7a plus or minus of 7a is equal to 0. So, any number and its additive identity, if you add it, you are getting 0. So, which property this is? Additive identity. Eighth one, multiplicative identity. X into 1 by x. X, x cancel. You are getting 1 as the product. So, it is multiplicative inverse. Sorry. The seventh one is additive inverse. Eighth one is multiplicative inverse. Now, ninth one. 2 into x plus 2 into 6 is equal to 2 into x plus 6. Reverse they given. This is what? Distributive law. Distributive law. LHS they should give A of B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. But here they given first AB plus AC is equal to A of B plus C. No problem. Both sides will get same answer only. So that's why for confusing you, they given like that. It will come under distributive law only. So ninth one is distributive law. Now all of you noted that answers now. Now come to the second one. Write the additive and multiplicative inverse of the following. So only additive inverse, multiplicative inverse you have to write. Now minus 3 by 5. What is the additive inverse of minus 3 by 5? Additive means what I said? Additive inverse. Plus you have to take. Minus 3 by 5 is there. So plus 3 by 5. Then what is the multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 5? For each bit you have to write additive as well as multiplicative. So what is the multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 5? Reciprocal you have to take. Sign will not change. See here minus 3 by 5. What is the multiplicative inverse? 5 by 3. Reciprocal you have to take. But sign a sum will write like this. But don't write minus negative sign in the denominator. Always the negative will be in the numerator only. Not in denominator. Only the reciprocal fraction will change. Understood? So, additive inverse is plus 3 by 5. Multiplicative inverse is minus 5 by 3. Like that each bit you have to write additive as well as multiplicative inverse. Now fill in the blanks. You have to fill. Why? Which property you will get? Property name no need. By seeing the LHS and RHS, what is missing? That you have to write. Okay? First bit already I explained. Second bit also I explained. Now third one you have to do class work and say again notes will not be given. Understood? Clearly I am explaining. Please note down and maintain the class work neatly. Then fourth sum, exercise 1.1, fourth sum, multiply 2 by 11 by the reciprocal of -5 by 14. Multiply 2 by 11 by the reciprocal. What is mean by reciprocal? Now, interchanging of numerator and denominator is called reciprocal. Now, reciprocal of -5 by 14. So this you have to solve. How can you solve? First, what he is saying? 2 by 11 you should multiply by its reciprocal. -5 by 14 reciprocal you have to write first. So the reciprocal of -5 by 14 is -14 by 5. That is the reciprocal. After that you have to multiply 2 by 11 by -14 by 5. So multiply 2 by 11 by -14 by 5. That is equal to 2 by 11 into -14 by 5. Listen here, is there any cancellation for numerator and denominator? Like this you can cancel, like this you can cancel, but don't cancel numerator into numerator and denominator into denominator. That is a wrong way. Understood? Now, here any possibility is there? No. So, what you have to do? You have to multiply numerator into numerator by denominator into denominator. Now, plus into minus. Minus. 2 14s are 28 by 11 5s are 55. So, this is the answer. Minus 28 by 55 is the product of this two. Understood? Question first you read 2-3 times. Then only you can understand what is given, what you have to do. Okay? Without reading this reciprocal, just you are multiplying 2 by 11 into minus 5 by 14. You won't get this answer. Understood? So, read the question thoroughly. 2-3 times you have to read and write. Now, homework is exercise 1.1. Exercise 1.1. Up to 4 sums we completed. Now 5th, 6th. Okay, that's 2 enough. Remaining I will say next session. Remaining sums I will explain. 5th and 6th sums. Our homework. These 2 sums are homework. Complete your classwork regularly. Okay, if you are pending, you can only get the trouble. Understood? So, complete the notes regularly. Check the homeworks. Okay, ma'am? I hope all are understood.